If you have sensitive skin and you cannot bear to wear wool, you may or may not have heard that alpaca wool might be a solution, and I'm going to give you an answer to that. My name is Evelyn from Yanantin Alpaca, and I love everything alpaca. If you do too, hit the like and the subscribe button and you'll be updated on all the cool facts that alpaca wool has to offer. When it comes to wool, people either love it or they run away just looking at it. If you have sensitive skin, wool can be very uncomfortable to wear. And the good news is there are actually some categories of alpaca wool that you can wear even when you have sensitive skin. When it comes to the softness of a fiber, it's actually very relative. And what is soft for me can be very coarse and prickly for you. So if people say something is soft, you want to be careful and you actually want to try it out on your skin first. The best places to do this is either on your arm, on the inside, or on your cheek or another part of your face, because those are most sensible and you will feel quickly whether or not a fiber is soft for you. If you get skin irritation, then take the fabric away as soon as possible and this should solve the problem. A more objective way to look at wool fibers is by looking at them in microns. A micron shows the thickness of a wool fiber, and there are some general rules that show whether or not a fiber will be prickly for you. Now, as a general rule of thumb, you can see that the smaller the micron count, the smoother the fiber. And this is because a smoother fiber has smaller scales, and the scales are the things that cause that prickly feeling, that uncomfortable feeling that you can have when wearing wool. So if you have a finer fiber, it will have smaller scales and those will be less protruding, which means that it will just cause less of a prickly feeling. As you can see in this table, generally everything below 20 microns is itch-free. Everything between 21 and 29 microns is itch-free for most people. And I say most here because this is the range that is very uncomfortable to wear still for people with sensitive skin. And then generally everything above 30 microns is itchy for everyone, no matter whether you have sensitive skin or not. The good news is royal alpaca and baby alpaca are actually between 18 and 23 microns. So these categories should be fine for almost everyone. But like I said, it can still be different for you depending on your skin and what you feel comfortable wearing. So if you find a piece of alpaca woolen garment that is from the category royal or baby, test it first, but you might find that this is comfortable for you to wear. Medium alpaca is generally between 23 and 28 microns. This means that it is exactly in that category of mostly itch-free, but it will depend on you on whether you will find alpaca wool from this category itch-free or not. Another general rule when it comes to the softness of alpaca wool is that it is generally softer than sheep wool. So if you have a fiber from alpaca wool at a certain micron count, and you compare it to a fiber of, let's say, regular sheep wool or cashmere or any other woolen fiber, you will see that alpaca wool has a smoother fiber texture than all the other fibers. And this is why alpaca wool generally does feel softer compared to other wool fibers. Like I said before, it will depend per person on whether or not you will find an alpaca woolen garment itchy or not. And the best way to go about this is by testing it out on your skin. So by doing this, you will know for yourself which wool will feel soft for you and which wool doesn't. And as soon as you find out more or less the micron count that is comfortable for you, you can have a better idea of the type of wool that you can wear. Now, the micron count is not something you will often find on the label of an alpaca woolen garment, but it is definitely something that every producer of alpaca woolen clothing or accessories will know. So if you see an alpaca woolen garment that you might like, reach out to the brand or to the owner and they will be able to tell you. There's another couple of things that can influence the quality of an alpaca woolen fiber. And I mean, generally not even a single alpaca can give you a constant fiber texture. It will depend on the area that is shorn, so there are softer and less soft parts on an alpaca. It will depend on the detergents that are used during the production process. It will depend on whether or not it is dyed. And like I said, not a single animal can produce a uniform fiber. So while you can figure out the micron count that works for you, if you have very sensitive skin, take all these things into consideration and feel what feels good for you. If you like this video and if you want to learn more about alpaca, check out this other video that I made, and don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and you'll be updated on all the new videos with all the cool fun facts that I will share about alpacas. Stay warm, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.